Hey everyone, it's great to have you back on our channel. Scientists once dismissed this minuscule cell particle as mere waste, but recent discoveries have revealed a surprising twist. Today we'll explore how these tiny wonders, called exosomes, have changed our approach to general wellness therapies in ways we never imagined. Exosomes are tiny packets released by cells that carry proteins, lipids, and genetic material. They form inside structures called multivesicular bodies, then move to the cell boundary, eventually getting released. The Regeneration Center has found that while not as powerful as isolated MSC stem cells, exosomes can complement stem cell therapies. By enhancing their overall effects, exosomes can transfer molecules from one cell to another, almost like a delivery system. This cargo can include RNA strands, enzymes, and signaling compounds that guide cellular responses. By passing these elements between cells, exosomes enable a level of communication that was once overlooked. Some view exosomes as clues to what is happening inside the body, since they reflect the health status of their parent cells. Their structure allows them to resist certain degradation pathways. These micro-sized particles have been detected in fluids such as blood, saliva, and even urine, making them relatively simple to isolate for study. Because of this, our research team has gathered more insights on cell interactions at the smallest scale. One major function of exosomes involves guiding immune responses. When certain cells dispatch exosomes, they can deliver instructions that either activate or calm parts of the immune system. For instance, a damaged cell might send signals through its vesicles that recruit immune cells to clean up and repair tissue. In other cases, exosomes might keep inflammation under control by sending inhibitory messages. This helps the body regulate its defenses in a balanced way, preventing excessive attacks on healthy tissue. Some researchers have hypothesized that exosomes may even help spread signals in cancerous processes, which means understanding their role has become a major focus in disease research. Because they carry markers from their cells of origin, exosomes can also offer a snapshot of how healthy or damaged a cell might be. Exosomes can originate from many cell types, including adult stem cells, immune cells, and even various microorganisms. We isolate exosomes from mesenchymal sources to help in anti-aging and general wellness treatments. Exosomes from immune cells could one day be used to treat autoimmune disorders. Each source appears to impart unique traits, giving exosomes different strengths for different types of interventions. We are especially attentive to how these vesicles target specific tissues, thanks to proteins on their surface that guide them to certain cells. We are developing new ways to concentrate exosomes and apply them directly to areas that need a boost. Our unique laboratory-grade protocols often involve extracting exosomes from cell cultures, purifying them, and then testing their effects on specific tissues. The advantage is that exosomes are relatively stable and can pass through certain biological barriers more easily than whole cells might. In wound care settings, exosomes could be delivered as part of topical applications, targeting local injuries more efficiently. In orthopedic contexts, specialized exosomes could be injected alongside MSC cells to assist in rebuilding cartilage and repairing damaged tissue. Beyond physical injuries, some researchers predict that exosomes could also assist in neurological conditions by supporting damaged neurons and improving the cell signaling process. These possibilities spark hope for less invasive strategies that make use of human cells' own messaging tools. While direct MSC stem cell therapy often involves transplanting living cells, exosome-based methods focus on the signals these cells release. This approach carries fewer risks related to immune rejection, since exosomes typically have low immunogenicity profile. We are also examining whether exosomes can reduce complications that sometimes occur with cord blood stem cell transplants. Another area of interest is how best to scale exosome production for clinical use. Large quantities of exosomes are needed for widespread therapies, yet producing them in bulk without losing quality can be difficult. We are working to refine techniques for loading exosomes with beneficial molecules. If done properly, this could lead to the targeted delivery of bioactive materials and help improve our treatment's overall outcomes. In real-world settings, some doctors have already begun offering exosome-based interventions, although much of this remains experimental. Safety evaluations are very important to confirm that exosome preparations do not introduce harmful effects. Contaminants can slip into batches during production, so strict protocols must be followed. These steps help us weigh potential benefits against any unknown risks. While early trials are showing promising results, it takes time and rigorous oversight to reach general acceptance. Still, the growing interest highlights the enthusiasm around these small vesicles and their place in tomorrow's medical toolkit. With these insights in mind, it's clear that isolated exosomes stand at the forefront of medical research. Their capacity to influence immune responses, encourage tissue repair, and possibly deliver targeted therapies makes them a promising tool at our disposal. The Regeneration Center continues refining methods of isolating, customizing, and applying these vesicles to improve treatment outcomes. Now, if you'd like more information about regenerative therapies, head over to our main channel for other advanced medical approaches we use in treatments today. If you found this video helpful, give it a thumbs up and share it with anyone who might benefit. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel for more health tips and stem cell updates. Remember to like, comment, and ring the notification bell so you never miss an update. Thanks for watching, and we'll catch you in the next one. Bye, everyone.